We are replacing the speakers on a 2011 Chevy Silverado. Jeff's here. This is his truck.
Holler.
There he is.
Hey, what's up, guys?
All right, so explain what the heck's going on.
Okay, so what we're doing right now is we're about to replace the factory speakers on a Chevy Silverado. So what we're showing you right now is a site that's already completed. And what we can do right here to save you guys some money and some hassle trying to find brackets, you can still use the factory brackets with a compatible aftermarket speaker. This right here is a Rockford Fosgate three-way audio 6.5-inch speaker. Now, normally it's not just going to fit right in, so what you have to do is do a little bit of modifications to the original speaker brackets. Okay, so today for this project, we'll be using a DeWalt automatic screwdriver kit. It's got a 10mm socket set on here. I'm gonna use a little torque screwdriver just to kind of pop the covers right here. We are also gonna use a Dremel 3000. The Dremel tool will be able to custom fit the speakers in the box. And to make a solid connection, we'll be using a Weller soldering iron. And to heat up the heat shrink, we'll be using a Drillmaster heat gun. First thing you're gonna do for a 2007 to 2013 Chevy Silverado is you're gonna pop off the cover right here. And right here, take your, a small little flathead screwdriver torque, just kind of wiggle out. It should pop right out, as so. Take your 10mm right here. I'm just trying to wiggle around and sort of find where this thing opens up. Grab that cover off. And also, anytime AB's working on any sort of car interior, please, please, please keep an account where you put all your screws. They're not hard to lose. And there's nothing worse than losing your 10mm socket set. It is a freaking nightmare. You're gonna pull off the power window for the door. So again, pop that off right here. Press the tab right here, loosen it up. And at this point right now, you should be able to just kind of pull out and one more step. Pull the top right here. And voila, bam, there it is. And now what you're left with is the custom speaker right here. This is a 5.25-inch stock 2007 to 2013 Chevy Silverado rear speaker. These are crap, they're all from Mexico. Don't buy shit from Mexico, it all sucks. Buy only American-made speakers, gosh darn it. All right, here it is. Again, that's why you need your 10mm. Pop that off. And next we're gonna cut around the speaker right here with a screwdriver. All you gotta do is wiggle this out, pop. That's it. Now, some people wanna use speaker, I guess they're just their connectors or wherever they are, or. Personally, I'm gonna cut these right here and solder them together. Okay.
Now it's like an unboxing video.
Yeah. Presenting from Amazon. Can we say that Amazon on this thing?
Sure, why not?
Okay, cool. Okay, we got Rockford Fosgate 6.5-inch three-way speakers.
Dude, not only can we say Amazon, we could put an affiliate link in the description of the video. Okay. So people can buy the exact speakers that you're installing right now.
That'd be sick. Okay. Now, one thing you guys will notice right here is that if you look at the size of the speaker and the size of this speaker, this one's considerably bigger. Not by much, but it's probably, inch and a quarter inch difference. So as you can tell right here, this whole speaker is overlapping that bracket right here. So how are we gonna make that fit, you ask? Well, I'm gonna show you guys. First thing you're gonna do is this. Take a pair of cutters right here. Start at the top. in mind, I don't care about saving the speakers right now. They're about to go in the trash. They're garbage. Dio, what's up, buddy?
You gonna help out, bud? Oh, yeah.
There you go. Go and rip this guy out right here. Push this out right here. Tear all this out. All this shit, all this stuff out. Try to get all this adhesive off. All this, all the foam off as well. You're gonna want as much room as you possibly can to fit your new speakers in here. Because either way, this whole ring right here is about to come out. So again, just kind of make room for your Dremel. Pop this out right there. So all right, you got your bracket right now, but as you can tell, this will not fit. I still need clearance because I still have this whole ring right here. So instead of trying to force it to make it fit, we're gonna go ahead and Dremel around here. That way we have a, you know, a perfectly custom fit for a larger speaker size using a stock bracket. Kind of take your time, go around with the Dremel tool, and as you're Dremeling, try to get these areas as smooth as possible and not break through the plastic. So I get this whole ring off right here. This whole ring is what we're trying to remove, these little brackets around here if we can. That's the idea.
My niece and nephew sent me a lollipop and a sloth mask for Valentine's Day.
So what we're trying to do right now is get this hole a little bit bigger. So we're gonna sink the Dremel tool just to the edge of the bracket and just kinda go all the way around the ring to give this speaker just enough room. So we're trying to more or less get this whole thing out right here. And lower the speeds a little bit to kind of buff this out just a little bit. Get some of the excess right here. Trying to smooth out some of these edges right here so the speaker sits nice and flush. As you can see, the hole's bigger now. So right now, the speaker should be able to fit. And just like that, like a glove. Bam, and there it is, boom. Okay, and now what we're gonna do is this. We're gonna take a set of screws, and I forgot my little starter bit, so I'm gonna have to try to muscle these screws by hand, well, with my drill, and kind of hope for the best. So you probably need to put maybe, honestly, three or four screws max, not too many. Try to get the corners. So now that your speakers are flush to the corners, you're gonna look for one of these little holes right here, and just kind of line it up and see if you can get to touch the plastic.
Oh, so you're gonna go all the way through and yeah, the bottom here.
Okay. Right. So it's gonna just kind of, it's gonna have to go all the way through. You just need to latch on and make it secure. So what you're gonna kind of do right here is just kind of tap it here, and then since I don't have my since I don't have my starter bit, we're gonna have to kind of muscle it down a little bit. So the first one's always a little bit harder. Once you get the first one in, they're a little easier from here. There it is. Okay. So all you need about is a couple screws right here, and as you can see, there's no gaps, not wiggling around, not loose. Okay. Pick it up, it's pretty.
I'm gonna get a close-up shot of it.
Sure.
So the screw goes completely through the other side.
Yeah.
Cool.
Because like I said, it's pretty snug and secure in there. It's definitely not going anywhere. And next step, what we're going to do is start soldering the wires together. A couple methods you can do. You can either go all out and solder. You can get crimpers from Napa, or they have the wiring harnesses you can buy from Amazon or whoever else sells car audio parts. The the schematics online. The dark blue wire is your positive wire, and the light blue is going to be your negative wire. Why is this important? Because the way the positive and negative works for continuity of the signal for the speakers. If the reverse, the speakers will suck in, not push out. You want the speakers to reverberate sound outward. So that's why the positive and negatives have to be in a correct order. So what we're going to do is kind of give ourselves a little more room. Take an X-Acto knife right here and just kind of cut this jacket right here. Cut away from yourself a little bit like that. You don't need a whole lot of room, just kind of enough to, you know, strip and solder. So, you know, try to get a little bit out right here. And just like that, we'll have enough space. And then you take your wire strippers right here, lightly strip around this right here with your thumb, pushing the stripper away while holding this right here. Pull. Same with the other side. Next, we're gonna use the jumpers that came with the speaker kit. And one thing you'll notice about this particular model is that one terminal is slightly smaller than the other terminal. As you can see, this one's thinner, this one's thicker. So, and I noticed the speakers, the positive side right here is the thicker one, because you see the red wire going this way, and the negative side is going to the smaller one. So what you'll have to do is put the thicker terminal right here on the positive wire, and the smaller terminal on the negative side. We're using a welder soldering iron, some resin core from Radio Shack. That's how long I've had this for. a tip cleaner to clean your soldering tip, and a little bit of flux to transfer the heat. Oh, and also some heat shrink to heat together. Strip these ends right here. Again, from a previous video, just strip them like this. Push off. Put your heat shrink on. I know probably some of y'all should have said, well, why don't you put your heat shrink on the first time around before you stripped it? You're right, I just fucked that step up. So here we go. Okay, this right here goes to the blue wire right here. Not gonna be super secure, but once we solder it together, it'll stay put. And now what we're gonna do, clean the tip of our soldering iron like this. Oh, actually, put a little flux right here.
What does the flux do?
Transfer the solder. Okay. The flux will allow the solder just to kind of, catch on a little more cleanly. I mean, you don't have to have it, but it really does help transferring the solder across the joint. Now, probably a lot of you guys, if you're watching soldering videos on YouTube or anything like that, they're always in a controlled environment where they're, you know, in a lab. They have a something holding it together. This right here is going to be moving a little bit, so it's going to be a little more challenging. So what you're going to do is put the soldering iron at the bottom right here of the wire, and put the resin on top, or the flux on top. Or sorry, Jesus. the solder on top. So you tint the joint a little bit like this, tint it around, knock off the extra solder. And just kinda.
So you're going under the wire.
Yep.
And the solder's on top.
Yep, trying to get it hot. You don't want to touch the soldering iron with the actual solder, because it'll stick together. So what you're gonna want to do is kinda get it close. And as you can see, it's starting to transfer. little more there. Get the other side right here. As you can see, my solder is not, my flux is not, the soldering is not touching the soldering iron. The soldering iron is simply providing heat. That's going nowhere.
Cool. We should mention though, we're gonna go with electric tape instead of the heat shrink now because we couldn't get
it over. I made a mistake in the heat shrink got a little hot from the solder, so I wasn't able to push it through. So instead of this time, we're just gonna use some electrical tape. And no big deal. The whole cost of it anyway was just to make sure that the exposed wire is not touching anything like bare metal or shorting out with the other, the bare speaker wire. But tape will work. Let me grab this. Shit, these green ones are bigger too.
Oh,
fuck, man. I forgot all about them. Okay, so now right here we got the wires together right now. You're gonna put the hook up the terminals right now. Hook up the thicker terminal right here to the positive, and then the smaller one to the negative. Just like that. Take your 10 millimeter right here and flush it against the speaker. Is there any safe music we could play on this thing?
Oh, we could play the theme song to the podcast.
Let's do it. And before I look like an asshole, let me just test it out real quick.
Yeah.
So it's just like, oh. And crickets. All right. The door's put back together, and now let's go ahead and put on, let's put on the podcast theme. Let's do it. Yeah, man.
Go ahead, sign off.
All right, guys, I'm Jeff Goodrow, and we're going ahead and signing off. Can we do that one?
Yeah.
Alright, I need to be Ron Mexico, sorry.
Okay.
I fucked up with my name. Okay. Alright, cool. Alright, guys, this is Ron Mexico. We're signing off. Damn, son. That's what the fuck.